Assalamu alaikum and very good morning to my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are healthy and happy at home. And alhamdulillah for that. So my dear students, this video for class 5. In previous video, we did a translation and two exercises, right? Now we are going to do exercise number 3. So first of all, our chapter number heading of our lesson, topic of our lesson, Usratu Hamidi. Usratu Hamidi means Hamid's family. So we did in previous video that Hamid's family are what they are doing. So his father is sitting on the chair and read the newspaper. His mother is cleansing the house courtyard with the broom. His grandfather is walking in the garden. His grandmother is watching the television. His younger sister is playing with the swing. Understood? And he is returned from the school in the evening. This kind of translation and some statement we did in previous video. And then we did two exercises. So now we are going to do exercise number 3. Number A with Kalimati Munasibati means filling the blanks with suitable words. As you can see on the board and as you can see in your book also, that in bracket there is two options they are giving us, right? We have to select which word is proper suitable with this statement. Understood? So first statement is that Abdul Uktu Sagiratu Ala, and then they are giving a space. So little sister playing on the what? On the tree or on the Rujuhatu. First of all, tell me the meaning of a Shajaratu. That meaning is the tree, and our Rujuhatu is the swing. So the little sister is playing on the swing. So our answer is Al Urjuhatu. Right? This is our answer. Second statement is Tunasikul Umul Bahatu Bil Furshati or Bil Miknasal. Means the mother clean house courtyard or hall. Al Furshat means brush and Al Miknasal means broom. So from which thing mother cleans in the house, I tell you now only that she cleaned the house courtyard in the room, and we called it in Arabic al-miknasatu. So bil miknasati. Understood? Fifth statement is factory. So muhasifatun means female employees, amiluna means male employees who is working any kind of company or any kind of place. Understood? So here you can see hunna. Hunna, that is a sign that the plural of feminine. So we choose here muhasifatun. So number 6 is Tusallimu, then they are giving a space alal waladi. So Tusallimu means we use this present tense for a feminine, right? So what we take from here, walad or walida. See, waladu is also here, waladu means boy. But walida means the mother. So the grandfather walking in the garden. Number 9 is dash Janisun alal kursi. See, here also you have to see Janisun means sitting. Alal kursi. If there is a feminine statement, then this is not Janisun, it is like this Janisun. Right? So we know here that this is the masculine statement, so we take here alumu or alabu. Alumu means mother and alabu means the father. So we should take here alabu. Means alabu, Janisun alal kursi, the father sitting on the chair. Number 10 is huwa dash jaridatu. See, huwa. What is this? This is the zamire munfasil. You are writing down these pronouns without any other word support. Understood? So, whoever we use for Vayu Nisarga Gari means singular name. which is here your problem. Means who are your problem in Jali Data? Means he reads the newspaper. Understood? One more time I repeat this five fill in the blanks. Number six is Tusakin Mai Tatu Alakwaladi. Means the mother, say salam of the mother greeting to the son. Aljatatu, number seven. Aljatatu Tushakin Tilfas. Means the grandmother watching the television. Number eight. Aljatu Yamshi Min Hakipati. The grandfather walking in the garden. Number nine. Al Abu Jalisu Al Kursi. The father sitting on the chair. Number ten is Huwaya Kravun Chari Data. Means he read the newspaper. Now we are going to do our exercise number 5. So fourth number exercise is the conflict only means used in sentences. So we don't have to do now this. So we will do our exercise number 5. What is that? Uktubul Jamha means write the plural. So first word is Abun. Abun means father. So its plural is Aba, right? Number two is Moon, means mother. So its plural is Ummaha. Number three is Baitun. So its plural is Buyutun. Number Madrasatun is the school and its plural is Madrasatun. Then